Hi everyone, hope you are doing well. In this video, we are going to create a very simple UI in the Spring Boot application. We have already built a bunch of APIs in our previous videos. We have built the REST APIs, and in this particular video, what we are going to do is to create a simple UI in the same Spring Boot application and then make the call to all the backend services. This particular video is a part of a series called as Software Engineering Bootcamp, where we are building the simple e-commerce website. So in the simple e-commerce website, we have built a bunch of controllers like get all products, add products to the cart, and eventually place the order. You can ignore the health check controller. It's just for the health check. It's not needed. But these are the three things which are there. We are going to make all the three calls in the UI in the Spring Boot application and then place the order. And basically, we are also going to manage the session. So you see, hi Anubhav. So this is coming from the session data. So all those things we are going to do. Let's quickly get started. So we have a backend application that's a Spring Boot application. And how do you integrate the UI into a Spring Boot application? For that, the first thing you do is to go to pom.xml and add this line, dependency time leaf. So this helps to serve the static data in the Spring Boot application. Now, once you add this dependency, what happens is that this resource folder starts to get served for all the static contents. So now here in the controller, so this is the home controller which I have, and you know, you can have whatever controller you want. So here it is get mapping on the root folder. So whenever a root folder is called, what I do is that I have this @ controller. So in the other places you see it's all @ rest controller, but here in the home controller we have @ controller, and then we have get mapping, and we set some of the key and value pair in this model object which is passed to us, nothing but key and value, and we return home. Now what happens is that when we return home as a string, the Spring Boot tries to find a file called as home.html in the templates folder. So in this home.html, this particular page will be rendered. Now this particular page will also need some HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So this page itself is the HTML page, and I'm adding one JavaScript and one CSS file. So the static content can be put inside the static folder and you can get it from here. So those are the references which you put. Now the key and value which were returned from the home controller, you have something called as given name. So I could write something like $ given name and it will show up in the UI like hi Anubhav. So that's how it will show. Then we have choose the product you wish to buy. Then you have tables. And here in the UI, you can create some of the divs for total value. So these are the products. Then we have total value, then address, then place order. When you go through the HTML, you will realize it's a simple HTML with table, head, body, nothing else. It's nothing special here. Now, this has two files. One is the JavaScript file and the other is CSS file. The CSS file, home.css, it's just a styling, adding padding, etc. so that this UI looks good enough. You can actually go to W3 schools and there you can learn about CSS. But even if you don't have CSS, you can still make it work. Then the second is the JavaScript file. Here a lot of things are written. So the thing is, we have document.addEventListener. This is a plain JavaScript thing that, you know, how to make the call. Different constants are declared. Then what I'm doing is that I'm creating some functions like fetch product and cart details. So I'm just making get cart and get product API call, which is the product API call is this and cart API call is this. I'm making the call and then overall rendering the value to the UI. So, and then I'm updating the total value. So I don't want to get into a lot of detail, but here you see a bunch of things happening. The moment the JavaScript loads, it will fetch all the products from the backend and it will fetch the cart detail from the backend. And then it will render the product table, all the details in the product. It will render the total value in the cart from the, you know, whatever value it got. So if the cart has, let's say, two things of 100 rupees and 50 rupees, so it will render total value of 150 rupees. Then it will overall show the place order button. And then we have the render product table method where I'm rendering all the products. So I'm just having the products API, which renders all these things. And the last two columns are from the cart table. So I have this particular APIs for get product. So I can call get product and it will give me all the products, and the cart call will give me all the details of my cart. So I just have to join this data, the cart data and the products data. So these are the products and these are the cart which is available, right? So this is the info which is already available. Now you can keep on adding products to the cart. Like you can add product with ID 1 to the cart, and that I think will get added with the help of API. I added product with ID 1 to the cart and now the cart has this value. So those things are being called in here. I can just reload and show you. So this is how things look like overall in the UI. So you can keep on adding values here in the backend and that will show up. And then we have a place order API, which is this one, order/place. So these are the APIs which are being called from the front end, and especially the JavaScript code. So HTML has just the template, like what all things we want to show in the UI. The CSS is just for the beautification, and the JS has all the logic of making the API call to the backend. So JavaScript calls make the call to the backend and get the data. So for example, let's reload this thing. And Anubhav is someone who has logged into the website, and this is the base path. Now I can add, let's say, one bulb. Let's add one bulb, and you see the place order button became active and this one bulb is added to my cart. Then let's add one book also. So it will add one book as well, 480. Let's add two bulbs. We can add one more bulb. My idea is to convey how things work. So these things are added. I can put the address as, you know, something good. For example, 404, and then we can put Bengaluru, and then we can put Karnataka, and then 560106, and then India. We can put whatever we want, and then we can place the order. So when we place the order, it shows the order is successful and the person can take the screenshot. Now I can add many things if I want to. I can send a successful mail to the customer and all those things. So these things are happening using the API call. Now what's the advantage of using the APIs is that, let's say I duplicate the tab and let's say I add something to the cart now. So let's say I added one item. Now I reload. Still my items are there because these items are getting saved in the backend. So I have a database for cart, products, everything. This is the order detail. Now in the backend, as a product owner, I can go to the orders and I can do where ID is equal to 13 to see what is the order. So I can click here and see the order detail, order is placed. From the backend, I can check what orders are placed. I can create UI for the back, for the admins as well, that, hey, what are the orders which are placed? What's the status of various orders? So those things I can do if I want to, but it is a very simple one page HTML, right? But I can keep on adding things if I want to. So this is for the select star from orders. And then I can check what are the things which are already in cart. So I can see one is in a pending state. These two are in a pending state for two different users, user ID 1 and user ID 2. And I have the user details. So in the backend, I can keep on getting the data. I can add products if I want to, if I have more things in my grocery or my e-commerce website, I can keep on adding. So yeah, I hope this was helpful. It's a very simple UI to work with and integrate everything. So just to summarize, we added in the templates folder home.html. So whenever a controller is called, this home.html is rendered, and then from this home.html only I have some JavaScript and some CSS to do the further actions and make the further calls. So I had to add one controller only, that's a home controller, to render the plain HTML. And then that plain HTML makes further calls to all the REST APIs. Till the next time, bye.